हाय एवरीवन, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन अबाउट सिमुलेशन ऑफ बक कन्वर्टर। बिफोर गोइंग टू मैटलैब सिमुलेशन, फर्स्ट वी विल सी द ऑपरेशन ऑफ बक कन्वर्टर। बेसिकली बक कन्वर्टर इज यूज टू कन्वर्ट हाई इनपुट डीसी वोल्टेज टू लो आउटपुट डीसी वोल्टेज एट द लोड टर्मिनल्स। इन अदर वर्ड्स, इट इज यूज टू कन्वर्ट लो इनपुट करंट टू हाई इनपुट करंट। मीन्स इट इज स्टेपिंग अप द करंट लेवल्स, stepping down the voltage levels. So we can say current boost converter. For this converter we need control power electronic switch and diode and inductor and capacitor and load. So for control power electronic switch we can use MOSFET or IGBT. Okay, for the controlling action with help of duty cycle we are controlling the switch here. By varying duty cycle we can able to control voltage levels at the load side. So now we can see the modes of operation. During switch on state, that time diode is in off state, so that time inductor is charging and current path will be like this. During switch off state, inductor is having some charge, so it has to discharge. So inductor is discharging through the freewheeling diode. So these are my basic calculations regarding buck converter. This is my data corresponding to the buck converter. Input voltage is 12 volts, duty ratio is 0.6, switching frequency is 10 kilohertz, load power is 100 watts, ripple in inductor current is 10% of I naught, means load current. Ripple in capacitor voltage is 1% of output voltage. These are my basic formula, V naught equal to dVs. So from the given data, you can substitute here all the values and you can able to get V naught. And from the power balance equation, we can able to get I naught value. After finding I naught value, you can able to find the ripple in inductor current and ripple in capacitor voltage. So after completion of these calculations, we have to design L and C and also R value. From the above values, we can able to design inductor and capacitor and resistive values. After completion of all parameter design, we can go for MATLAB simulations. Before that, we can see the waveforms of buck converter. If you observe the waveforms, during on state inductor is going to charge with the slope of this value. When switch is going to off condition, that time inductor is going to discharge with a slope of this value. Okay, now we can go for MATLAB simulations of buck converter. So this is the Simlink a new file. Here you can find library, so you can search whatever you want, otherwise you can go directly. So I need power guy, so I am taking power guy block from here. Just click and add to model. And what else we want? We need switch, diode and inductor, capacitor and pulse generator and all. So go to Simscape and click on power systems and click on specialized technology, click on fundamental blocks. Already we have taken power guy and we need voltage source, DC voltage source. So we are adding this one and just come back in elements. What we want, just add series RLC branch and come back, and we need measurements. So for this converter we need to measure current and voltage. So I am adding current measurement and voltage measurement. So just come back, and we need switches also. So we need diode and one IGBT with anti-parallel diode, both I am adding. So I need one more, that pulse generator. I need this pulse generator. I'm adding to the order. So everything is overlapped. So just just take separately and you can connect as per your circuit diagram. Okay. Just click on the switch, make this an uncheck and apply and OK. Click on this diode, uncheck this measurement port and apply and OK, and flip this element. And what is our source voltage? That is 12 volts. Enter the value and apply and OK, and just connect to the switch. And this also connect to the diode. Okay. And click on pulse generator. And what is our frequency? Our frequency is 10 kilohertz. So we need to enter in terms of time period. So 1 by 10,000. Apply and okay. But here, what is our duty cycle? Our duty cycle is 0.6, means we need to enter in terms of percentage only. So 60% of duty cycle. Just connect like this. And we need to take inductor and capacitor. So what is our inductor value? Our inductor value is 207.343 e power of minus 6, means 207.343 micro henry. Click on apply and OK. And copy this element, make this element as capacitor. What is our capacitor value? 247.329 micro farad. Enter the value and click on apply and OK. And just connect. And this capacitor you need to flip. Just connect this inductor, and here we need to measure inductor current. So we are keeping current measurement. After this, what we are keeping here? We are keeping this capacitor that we are connecting like this. So copy this one, make this as an resistor. What is our resistance value? 0.518 ohms. Apply and OK. Just connected across the capacitor. So where we need to measure the voltage, that we need to measure across the capacitor. Okay. Everything we kept. So we are connected current measurement and voltage measurement. For that we need scope. Just type scope. So add scope from the library. And click on the scope. And you can enter the number of displays you want. We need 3, so apply and OK. And click on this one. We need to make as a 3 blocks. Okay, so it will measure 3 blocks separately. Okay, so first I am measuring this one. And second, I'm keep connecting to inductor, and third terminal I'm connecting to capacitor voltage. So after that, I'm giving runtime as a 1, and I'm running. So this is an main block. If you want to measure average value, you can connect this main value to this one, main block to this one, and you can connect this main block to voltage and current also, and you can connect a display. Okay, then run, click on run. So it is displaying the results. So you can able to just zoom in. What's our fashion unit? Just vertical zoom. You, if you want, you can do it in vertical way. If you want horizontal. So this is my pulse. See, if you observe when switch is on condition, that time inductor is charging, and when it is off condition, it is discharging. Like this, it is coming. So if you see the results from the theoretical calculation, you can verify whether you are getting your theoretical calculations are matched with the simulation results or not. Okay, this is what simulation of buck converter. Okay.